This region's oldest wine and food festival is also one of the best. The 29th annual Hilton Head Island Wine and Food Festival starts tomorrow and runs through next Saturday, when locals and tourists alike turn out to try some of the best wines on the island.
Oh, definitely, definitely. People love their food down here and they love to drink with it.
Until then, though, the food will take center stage.
We do want to do such a good job with it that we do spend a lot of our energy in making ours the best we can make it.
The Old Fort Pub is a staple on the island, wowing its guests since 1973. They look forward to this week-long celebration as a showcase not only of their chef, but of the entire island's talents. And there is lots of it.
Food's always formal, and the wine's always great, but the crowd and the energy is always very fun.
Michael Serafisi has been on the island for about 12 years, owner and executive chef at Ombra the last year and a half. So he's got a pretty solid grasp on what this festival and island cuisine is all about.
The menu is classic Italian. If it's a dish from a certain part of Tuscany, it should taste the same or look the same as if you went to Florence next week for dinner and saw it.
No shortage of seafood either on the Carolina coast. It is absolutely expected.
But our biggest deal is fresh fish, getting it right off the back of the boat, cutting out the middlemen. I spend a lot of hours of the day breaking down whole fish.
Sean is the executive chef of Redfish, one of the more popular seafood restaurants on the island.
Growing up in Hawaii, I definitely have a love for the good seafood and fresh fish.
And he'll have it too. All three of these restaurants we've shown you will be hosting wine dinners on Thursday the 13th. Old Fort Pub, Redfish, or...
You know, the menu that they have for their wine dinner here just sounds off the charts amazing. I won't bog you down with all the details, but you can find it on their website, Ombra, O-M-B-R-A, Hilton Head Island.